Hey guys, welcome back to
the Fresh Street Podcast.
We are missing Joaquin today.
He overslept. He was very tired. Yeah. Something, boys. I don't know. I always blame him on him being a boy. Oh, you're right. A boy.
That's why you overslept.
He doesn't
just come with you?
No, he has his own vehicle. That's a whole other story. We have a guest today. It's Miss Cherub.
That's me.
Is that Cherub?
No, Cherub.
Some people say cherub.
Oh, I hate cherub. It's cherub.
So it's like syrup, but with a C.
But not.
Oh.
Yes.
Got it.
It's Ukrainian.
Oh,
well, there's the problem. Not from the Ukraine.
Yeah, we're not from the Ukraine. There's right. A big Ukrainian flag in my room.
Yeah, there is.
There is.
I thought you were just supporting Ukraine.
No.
So I was okay, she's woke. I got it.
Do you want to introduce yourself?
Yeah. All right, so tell us about yourself. Go.
I'm Elizabeth Cherub, and this is my first year at B-Port. I did B-Port. 9 years at B-Wood.
The hood?
Yeah, and then I figured out, oh my gosh, I need to come here. But actually, I did 1 year at Hitchcock.
Oh, that's even worse, bro.
Then I ran away, and I came here.
Go Bulldogs.
Go Bulldogs. Yeah. And so I'm here now, and I teach all of the AP English courses.
Yes.
So 5 different courses.
AP English 3, AP English 4,
research
seminar,
yeah. And then English 4.
English 4.
Yeah, I'm in her second period AP Lit class.
Because it's lit.
Lit is
lit. I think there's feedback. Is it me or is it me?
Yeah, there's feedback.
Just quit moving.
Okay. I'll quit moving. We just stand still.
Just stand like this.
Nobody move.
All right.
You didn't even introduce yourself.
Yeah, oh, my bad. I'm like, it's been, I feel like we've had a lot of technical issues.
Yes.
Disregard all the weirdness. My name is Hamilton, aka The Man, aka what are my other AKAs?
AKA, I swear, you have always said the big dog.
The big dog. Because yes. I'm the big dog. The big dog.
Oh, my gosh.
Bye.
With us is always Amaya.
Hi, I'm Amaya Ramos.
Why is there feedback? Maybe these are too loud. I don't know. We're just going
to... So many buttons.
Anyway.
Almost.
Ooh, that sounds better. Ooh, that sounds better. All right, there you go.
There you go.
We're missing Joaquin. Like I said, he overslept. He's a tired boy. Yes. Boys have lots of energies, I guess. I don't know.
Or they stay up too late.
I legit went to his room. It's like, hey, man, you coming?
I'm right here. Why?
I gotta go. That's crazy. I gotta go. We're good.
All right, let's jump into.
We're gonna jump into some topics. We got a couple of questions that we're gonna ask. C-Bub, I believe is how you say your name. Cheshire.
I plead the fifth.
All right.
Okay. So the first one is, what TV show would you be on, or like TLC TV show? It could be any TV show, but
are we saying?
I don't know why I said TLC.
I know. I don't know either. That's very weird.
I love TLC.
Hashtag to the 90s.
Yeah, it's very specific.
I don't know. I love TLC.
Can it be reality TV?
Yes. Sure.
Okay. I believe, and everyone should hear this because I think I could become rich doing this.
Okay.
Real teachers of Brazoria County.
That's not a thing.
It needs to be a thing.
Okay.
It needs to be a thing. It needs to be. It's like Real Housewives, but not as trashy. Teachers.
I like
teachers.
That.
I'm telling
Excuse
you.
Excuse me?
Okay.
Have you seen some of our teachers
I'm
in Brazoria County?
Saying.
We look trashy.
Okay, well.
Just saying.
Not on Tied Up Tuesday.
Oh, well, I would definitely say
Tied Up Tuesday, we look good. But I'm telling you, real teachers of Brazoria County, there's definitely a market in that.
I think that would be great. Honestly,
you know how much drama teachers have? The teacher drama is worse than the student drama half the time.
I mean, I guess in the English department, I don't know what y'all got going on in the English department.
No, but not in the English department. We just all these peoples and
there's
all
a lot of
these
peoples.
Feelings.
There's a lot of feelings. Yeah.
Big feelings.
I got things to say, but I'm not going to. We're keeping that on the DL, as they say in the streets.
Yeah.
I think we met like a show that was established, but you know what? You broke the rules, and you're a rule breaker, so whatever. I mean, it happens that way.
I'm okay with this.
Real teachers of the BC.
Why be on a TV show that already exists when I can create one?
Wow.
True.
Aim for the stars, guys. Aim for the stars.
Aim for the stars. And if you don't end up in the stars, you land in the moon or something like that. There's a quote like that.
I've never heard that quote.
Or the field.
Ever.
I'm not sure.
You know what? Just because you don't hear things
doesn't
mean
that
doesn't exist. Maybe. I make things up often. I tell random stories. Go
what
ahead.
TV show
oh, me?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. This is a great question. Mm-hmm. This is a great question. Probably is. I wish Chantal watches this episode. There's a show on Netflix called All of Us Are Dead.
What? You went on and on about that show last year.
Bro,
no,
it's such a good
year.
Show.
I think it was like 2 years ago. You
it's such a good show. It's a good
show.
It's a good show. So essentially, this Korean high school kids get trapped in it because there's a zombie apocalypse outbreak. Don't. I like zombies. Leave me alone. And there's like students and there's teachers and there's like, you know, it's a whole like high school drama, but it's also Korean and also there's zombies. I think I'd be great as like a teacher in that school that's like trapped in there with them and trying to help them get out. I might get eaten in an episode, but it'd be worth it because I'm saving the lives of my children.
I could see him being in a zombie apocalypse.
Oh, I would survive. Yeah. I know I would survive.
Even though you just said he might be eaten.
Well, for the TV,
yeah,
TV show purposes, but if it was real, listen, I'm a thick boy. I'm a thickens. Alright? I'm thicks. So I can go without eating for like 3 weeks before I had to find my first meal. I'll be alright.
That TV show just like the thumbnail of it looks gross.
Oh, it's disgusting.
Like it's
what's
like
it called again?
All of us are dead.
It's on the Netflix. They're coming out with the new episode soon.
Mm-mm.
Yeah.
No.
No, I
didn't even watch that show. It looks so 100%, nasty.
100%. Aside from that show, I've always thought myself to be a cook. I don't really know how to cook very well. Have you ever seen that show? Oh my god, it's where they go and make cakes and it looks horrible.
Oh, yes,
but
nailed it.
I would do that show all day.
Oh, that's good.
Because I think I could be could be bad at that.
Or the Great British Baking Show.
Oh,
another come on, they have accents. It's
you
great.
Have to be a good cook.
But yeah, you also have to be British, I think.
You can pretend to be British.
I don't think so.
I don't think
you
could.
Could
you pretend to be British? Can we hear it?
Go.
Good day, governor.
Why did I think you were just going to say in it? You were just going to say
in it. Yeah. One of my other favorite shows that I would love to be in, I have too many, but what is it called?
Favorite show, doesn't know the title.
Oh my lord.
While you're thinking of that, I used to tell my mom all the time, like, you should be on
Top Boy?
No, you should be on MasterChef. You should be on MasterChef.
Was it called Top
Cook,
it's a British show where there's drugs involved. It's fine. It's just a show on Netflix.
Oh, it's on?
I think it's called I think it's called Top Boy.
Oh,
Top Boy.
Yeah, they're like yardmen. Proper yardmen. In it. Go ahead.
I would definitely be on a reality TV show.
Yeah.
And like, I don't know, that's just like my personality. I feel like I would be on a
reality TV show.
If it wasn't, then I would most likely be casted on, like, a Nickelodeon or a Disney show.
I could see it.
Yeah.
The Sweet Life of Zack and Cody.
Yes, definitely.
Yeah, and you're, like, the best friend.
Exactly.
Or are you, like,
I'm like the love interest. I would be, like,
interest.
the ditzy best friend.
Oh.
That's what I would be.
I don't know. You're not ditzy. You might be the nerd.
Oh, she's ditzy.
I'm ditzy.
There's a lot of dits going on in that.
Yeah.
In that hair.
In my noggin.
You could be, or you could be like in the Sweet Life of Jack and Cody. You would be the love
interest.
And Cody. They would fight over you.
Oh yes, most definitely.
Snap it up! I'd love that. I also think that I would love to do. I don't know what you did with your head, and now your hair is crazy. So don't do that.
Fix it.
So much better. I know I could do. Not Survivor. Amazing Race. Me and my wife have talked about this. It's a show where
Is that like Survivor?
It's like couples go on essentially international road trips. Okay. So they go all over the world and like take flights, they take trains, they take cars, whatever they got to get from point A to point B.
Oh,
and they get like money. And then, so like they have to do activities, like whatever. And then while they're there, like they compete to stay on the show. I'm almost certain. Me and my wife love to travel. One, two, I think of myself as a pretty decent driver. And her navigation skills are on point.
My dad likes to call himself a four-generation trucker.
What?
Yeah, like, my family, like, they're, like, truckers.
Like 18-wheeler truckers?
Yes.
He does that too?
No, my dad doesn't do that.
Oh.
But he likes to call him a fourth generation trucker.
You mean a fourth generation?
Fourth, I was like four.
A fourth generation. He likes Ford trucks.
Okay, that's moment.
Fourth generation.
Fourth generation.
So like every time we go on a road trip, we're like, yeah, we're a fourth generation.
Just like that. I love your southern accent.
That's
there.
So good.
We're a fourth generation trucker.
Okay. I agree with all the things that you just said. So our next topic is going to be difficult for somebody.
Dum-dum-dum.
Because she doesn't do
that means
things.
Me. Oh, is it the concert?
Favorite concert.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Do you want to go first or do you want to go last?
I'll go first. That's okay. Fine. Let me just get it out of the way. First off, I am not a concert person.
Which is the weirdest thing
okay,
in the world.
Oh, my goodness.
I'm just
really?
Not. I've only ever been to 2 concerts in my life, and Marino says that the rodeo doesn't count. What was that guy's
name? I mean, it
kind
of
Paisley? What was his name?
Brad Paisley.
So I saw him at the rodeo, and then the only...
Yeehaw.
Mm-hmm. And then I went to the Woodlands for the first time. I think it was like 2014. I moved here in 2013 and I saw John Mayer. And I don't even like John Mayer. I'm
my
sorry.
Loves
I know, I'm crushing hearts. But my friend was so excited and he came out and he was wearing this black and red flannel shirt. Mm-hmm. And she just crooned. She lost it. She went, oh my God, look at his shirt. And I was like,
you're like
really?
Lame, bro.
Like, seriously? But I'm telling you, these older ladies, they were getting with it.
Your response to her was like, his body's not a wonderland.
What the heck?
Best joke of the day.
That
he gets that
John
one.
Mayer
he gets that one.
In case you didn't get that.
That was good.
I didn't.
Even I knew
you're
that.
Like,
and I'm not even a
like,
John Mayer fan.
You like, one.
It was a
wonder.
So yeah, other than that, concert.
That saddens me so much.
I'm sorry.
That saddens me so much. That really does. Like concerts are dope. Like they're really, like they're fun.
What do? You just stand there
and you jam out, bro.
Jam out in my car with a Starbucks and air conditioning.
That's awesome.
Okay. Although I agree with this concept that you're saying.
Can I go next?
Hold on. I'm just saying you're like, as a person that just assumed that you were really cool. This took it down 5 points, bro. Cool people go to concerts. That's what I said. Also, where are you from?
New York. Long Island, New York.
Long Island. I didn't know that.
Yeah, born and raised.
For some reason, I took you as a California kid. Like a West Coaster. I just offended
you. No, you didn't offend me. If you said Jersey.
Oh.
I would have had to take headphones off. I would have had to
walk
out.
Now you know if she's getting on your nerves.
Oh. Don't.
Is that the Jersey coming out? And she would get...
Oh, it's a thing. Like, Jersey and Long Island, New York.
We cannot tell Nick that.
Do not tell Nick
because
that.
Because Nick will definitely say it.
Why it will.
Yeah.
Definitely. New York.
Yeah. Concert, go.
I've been to 5 concerts. I'm going to my sixth concert.
For a lame artist.
Saturday. SZA.
SZA is spelled
S-Z-A.
She didn't even spell her name correctly.
We were looking her up in class, and she spelled S-I-Z-Z-A.
I'm an English teacher. I spelled it like the way it sounded.
Yeah, like, that's,
oh,
it. That's what SZA is.
S-Z-A. I was like, yes. But anyways, so I've been to Selena Gomez twice.
Really?
I like Selena Gomez.
Selena Gomez. Oh my gosh.
I like her show.
I literally...
You were crying.
I had a jacket with me. And I was little, so I was like, I don't even know why I was crying over this, but when she's saying Who Says, like, Who Says You're Not
Selena? Like, I know.
I was like,
I grabbed my jacket.
And my mom was like, are you crying?
So
and I was like,
your mom was
just
like,
because I'm so perfect.
Your mom was like, fronting on you. Like, no, seriously.
I was like, lame. So I've been to Selena Gomez twice.
Right.
Big Time Rush.
The country artist?
No,
they're a boy band.
Never heard of them. What?
They had a Nickelodeon show.
They're like the Jonas Brothers.
Oh, but not as Jonas.
But not as Jonas.
Got it.
And just big.
I've been to. Well, actually, Jonas Brothers had a Disney show, and then Big Time Rush had a Nickelodeon show.
Yeah.
But anyways,
okay.
And Disney's then I've been to Post Malone.
Really, you went to Posty?
Yes, I went to Posty.
Oh, no.
It was a really good concert. It was so good.
Yeah.
And then, this is gonna shock y'all, but I've been to New Kids on the Block.
Why?
You love I'm so proud of you.
I love you. There's no way you'd love them. You don't even know who they are. They're 85 years old.
But they're so good. So I went to their, it was their remix concert. It was in Houston.
It was like them.
No, it was
98 Degrees.
And then it was like Salt and Pepper. And then this other girl.
80s, early 90s.
Yeah.
Don't hate.
Like that.
I read something recently that those people who are doing those like reunion tours of like a bunch of groups are being more successful than like Lil Uzi Vert. Like his, I'm not hating on him. I'm just saying that like they're selling out while new artists are struggling to like sell tickets to the level that they're doing.
Correct.
I too kind of want to go to Lil Uzi Vert. I've had this conversation with Joaquin Lent recently. What are you looking at me for? I'm not going to take you, weirdo. You're so lame.
Well, I could go with Joaquin.
That's true.
Because I literally... If he wakes up. Have I not been talking about that in class, though?
Yeah.
I literally wanted like to go to Lil Uzi Vert.
Yeah, Cliff also talked about one ago.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Anyway, which of those was, like, your favorite thing you've been to?
New Kids on the Block was really, really good. That's all I got to say.
That's cool. Like, you went with, like, family or... Like...
I went with my mom and my sister.
Okay.
Yeah, so...
That's kind of cool.
Yeah, it was. It was, like, it was cool because they introduced, like, us to New Kids on the Block when we were, like... I was probably in, like, fifth grade.
Okay.
And fifth, sixth grade. And then, like, I don't know, I just, like, fell in love with them.
Yeah.
And then, can you turn me down a little bit? I'm kind of, like...
Are you loud?
Yeah. Not all the way down. No, that's too low.
Hello.
Right there.
Okay.
Okay.
I'm still, like, I feel like we're good, but not great. It's okay. We're making it happen.
Great. Yeah.
Oh, you feel great.
I feel great. My favorite song is Tonight. Tonight.
It's so good. You're dancing.
And then I found out, I don't even know his name.
Jordan Knight.
No.
Jordan
Knight.
Donnie Wahlberg.
Turns out, he turned out gay, and I found that out at the concert, and I was
sad. Jordan McKnight.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Sure. And I was like,
he's a good looking dude.
I was devastated.
You can still love him.
Did you assume, as a 10-year-old, you were gonna somehow hook up with? Like,
he wanted me.
Oh, that sounds so pedo. No, stop.
No.
He's like 7,500.
Oh wait, another concert I've been to. Why Don't We? I'm sure y'all don't know them.
Never heard of Why Don't We?
It was like it
Why
was
Don't We? Don't? We don't.
Sixth graders were obsessed with. I was obsessed with them. But yeah, so I went to one of their concerts. It was at House of Blues.
Oh, that's cool.
So
that's cool.
Yeah, it was like one of the little concerts or whatever. And then after that, it kind of like they kind of like died down.
Wow.
So.
It's because you were too big of a fan.
Can't imagine why.
Yeah. Concerts are a thing that we've been doing since I don't know how long.
Mm-hmm. You recently went to a concert, though.
Tuesday.
Yeah.
Yes. And yesterday was Wednesday, and it was a tough day. We went to go to the Core Four, which is like me, my wife, Joaquin, and my oldest son, JP. Mm-hmm. We don't, since JP went out to college, like we don't get to do a lot together. And we realized at the concert for the Foo Fighters, the last time we went to a concert together was the Foo Fighters when they came 5 years ago. But we've been, like, individually. But I've seen a lot. 21 Pilots, Imagine Dragons, Childish Gambino when he was first coming out as Childish Gambino. Man, I've seen at the Toyota Center. Who have I seen? A ton. We saw Deftones and Incubus at the Woodlands a couple years back. I've seen like really small venue shows with Death from Above. 1979 is one of my favorite bands. I said Incubus. I've seen Limp Bizkit a long time ago. I've seen Stained. I've seen Redman and Method Man. I've seen there's another rap concert I went to at least one time.
Drake.
No, I don't know if I would go see
Drake. Drake would be fine.
I really was sad that I didn't get to go see J. Cole when he came down last. We do a lot. It's one of the things that we do as a family. Mm-hmm. Me and my wife go to. We went to L.A. in April to see John Mayer's solo tour, and also we hung out in L.A. and that was dope. It's just something that we do. I feel like I have. Taylor Swift was one of my favorite concerts. I hate that I say that, but her 1989 tour was. The most, like, honestly, like, the best production I've ever seen in my life. And it was at Minute Maid, which is not a venue.
Album. Yeah. That was a really good album.
Minute Maid Park is not meant for concerts. Mm-hmm. But okay. her stage presence, it was...
I didn't know that they put on concerts there.
Yeah. Pink was there, like, 2 weeks ago.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
My sister loves Pink.
I would go see Pink in a heartbeat, fam. Yeah. Pink is dope. She, like, also, flies in the air, why are you talking so far away from that?
Because I'm really loud in my ear.
Your ear is weird. Let's try this. Is that better?
Okay. I'm right here now. Okay.
So, like, Taylor Swift is honestly one of my favorite concerts that I've ever been to. It was just so good. It was so stinking good.
You're a Swiftie.
No, because I
have, I think you're a Swiftie.
I had an opportunity to go to Eras. I had an opportunity to go in New Orleans next year.
Oh, okay.
But I turned down the ticket so that my niece could go. Because she's more of a Swiftie fan. What? They're going Sundays to watch the movie. And I'm not gonna watch
that. My sister wants to go to that.
Wait, what movie?
They're showing a movie in the movie theaters.
What? A movie in a movie theater?
But it's the concert.
Okay. Oh. Okay.
Yeah, so it's an Eras Tour concert, but in a movie, as a movie.
Popcorn.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
I know, with drinks. Foo Fighters is honestly my favorite. Like, when we went on Tuesday, they played every song that they, all of their known songs, some songs that were deep cuts, and we had really good seats to that venue. Oh, I forget all the, Jimmy Eat World, Yellow Card, Måneskin Twice. Oh my gosh,
Yellow Card.
Yeah, I'm just thinking about all these other countries that I've been to. Oh, I've been to a lot. Gosh. I wish I kept,
would you say, 20?
Probably more.
Oh, dang.
I mean,
sounds like it's been more than 20.
I'm not even including, the rodeo and, small venue stuff.
Oh,
yeah.
At the rodeo, I went to go see Camila Cabello.
I
don't like her.
Wow. Hey. I saw Bruno Mars at the rodeo. Oh. Another great performance.
Is he, this tiny?
Yes. are his backup dancers much taller, but way far in the back so you can't see him so much?
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah, that was on purpose because he is a tiny man. He is an itty-bitty dude. That's crazy. He's so small. 5'5", maybe.
Hopefully he doesn't listen to this.
Yeah, he's... Sorry, Bruno.
You'll never be allowed to.
He's Hawaiian, so he probably doesn't get it because, it's an island. They don't import exports. No.
Okay. Oh, my gosh.
Is that good?
That was good. That was good.
All right. So I love concerts. I think more people should go to concerts. More people should go to concerts.
Concerts are so fun.
I agree. We can't talk about the last topic that you wanted to talk about. Right. Cherub disallowed it.
That's so Cherub.
Cherub.
So Cherub.
We'll go Future Self.
Future Self.
We'll okay. My Future Self.
You're gonna go first.
I'll go first. Cool. Okay. So Future Self, I want to be a teacher. Yes.
I did know that.
Yes.
You told me that.
I did.
I want to be an English teacher, but yes.
Did you just roll your eyes hardcore at that?
Don't do it.
But if that doesn't
pan out.
Yeah. Then I'll probably do history. History is one of my, I love history so much. But anyways, so first things first or whatever, when I get out of college, I want to do intermediate school because I know that I can't do maybe fifth.
Ugh. Is that the lowest you would go, probably?
I think the lowest I will go.
Is it because of the boogers?
It's because
of the whining?
It's because of the, I don't know how to explain it. It's just they're too little. I don't know.
Oh, I got what you're saying.
It's just they're too little.
That makes sense.
And I know,
you can't have conversations with them.
Exactly.
No, you cannot.
Exactly.
No.
But sixth through eventually I want to be a high school teacher. But that will be
just start with high school. Jump right in.
I don't know. I feel like I will get disrespected if I just jump into high school. Yeah. So I don't want to do that. I want to just be with sixth through eighth probably.
Yeah. You can't go to a 1 year old and be like, so tell me what you think about the
exactly.
I want to be a firefighter.
Yeah.
No, idiot. That's not what I said.
And then they're the next day they're like, oh, I want to be a doctor.
Yeah.
Actually. I'm like, no.
I wanted to be a ballerina.
You still can't.
No, I mean, you
no,
can.
I can't.
But
50 pounds lighter.
I wanted to be a cop.
You still can. Yeah.
No, I'm good.
I'm totally
fine. Eakers, beakers.
Anyways, so I want to be a teacher, and then eventually right now, just in my head, I have the whole getting married situation and having kids, blah blah. That's what
she also wrote.
But I just eventually in my future, I just want to be happy.
Right.
That's it. I just want to be happy.
No, you don't. You want to have joy.
I want to have joy and be happy. And just like, I don't know. I just want kids so bad.
Yeah.
Not right now, but...
That side eye.
Not right now.
Not right now. I'm gonna be really happy to be a mother.
Yeah.
And that's all I want.
That means that we would be grand teachers.
Yes.
Yeah.
Did we become a teacher that we're like grand teachers?
Yeah. No, we were because she's our student. So she has kids.
Oh, and you know what's so crazy is that
I get it.
I love meeting my grand students.
I'm in the practicum class, so I'll be at FIS with 8th grade for 4 days out the week. And my old 7th grade teacher, I'm now going to be her assistant teacher, basically.
Oh,
so
that's good.
That's cool.
Yeah.
That's actually pretty
and
cool.
She was my favorite. Decide if you like the grade level.
Yeah.
And she was my favorite teacher in FIS, so that would be awesome. Miss Camilot.
I intend on being a billionaire. No, I don't. I hate that. You know what I'm looking forward to? I think we've had this conversation. I'm currently in the, I don't want my kids in the next 5 years, one of them, I don't care who, to have a kid. I want a grandkid.
Right.
I'm in that, like, I want to
I don't
be
think I've
Papa.
Ever heard someone say that.
I want to be like Pops or Papa.
Papa.
Would you choose your own name?
No, I'd let them call me whatever they want. That's weird when people are like, I want to be
Gigi.
Yeah.
My grandpa.
No, bro.
My grandpa was like, no, you're not calling me anything. My name is Grandpa. Like,
oh, okay. Sure.
No,
Grandpa.
I'm Grandpa.
Yeah. I don't want to be called Wilito, although I think that's cute.
Okay. I think that's for great, great.
Yeah, that's what we call like the like old.
Or grandpa. I call him Willow.
Yeah. But no, like, we're not ever having any more not. Jokingly, I'll be like, hey, babe, what do you think about? Don't say it. I'm like, I was joking. We're not having any more kids. But no, like, you know, the kids, the oldest one's about to be 21. You know what I mean? So, like, 21. So within 5 years, I think it's realistic to think that he'd have a kid.
Yeah.
And so I just want to be like the one that's the grandfather that spoils their grandkids. You know what I mean? And then, like, sugars them up.
And then sends them home.
And then buys them, like, really expensive things. And then sends them home and be like, don't break that.
Okay, so when Joaquin graduates and when he, like, goes to college, whatever. He's going to college?
Yeah.
Okay, when he goes to college.
Why'd you say that like that?
I was asking.
You're trying to say he's saying he's done?
Like, no, I'm just asking.
Joaquin, what do you say?
Remember, college isn't for everyone. So.
Joaquin doesn't even have words right now.
Exactly.
It has to be for him. We have a rule.
So.
Go ahead.
Yeah, that's my parents' rule too. Like, they're like, you have
to. Yeah, you gotta go to college.
I'm like, okay.
Get a degree, it's not that hard.
Yeah.
I mean, it is, but it's not that
so
hard.
So basically, after he graduates, and like, say that it's like 2 years after he graduates, would you still do like the whole foreign exchange student thing?
Oh, that's a great question. On that note, I think we need a break.
Okay.
We did a lot of years in a row, and it's a lot of money. Not, I mean, for us, like, right? We're not just gonna be like, stay home and hang out. Mm-hmm. Like, we like to do things. And so financially, it makes sense for us to take a little bit of a break.
Right.
But yeah, for sure.
Okay.
I'd like to get having five.
I just didn't know if you were fully done with it.
No. Having five girls, the five daughters is great. I'd like to have a few, like a couple more underneath the proverbial wing here.
Mm-hmm.
Because then, like, I think it'd be cool to, like, meet up and have a big, like, meal and
hang
out time with everybody. Yeah. And, like, they get to know each other. And, like, they talk to each other as well.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, we want to continue to have that trend of, like, all of them still communicate and all of us still communicate with them.
Mm-hmm.
I think we would. I keep telling my wife to, why don't we get some boys, and she's not for it.
Oh, really?
Yeah. But also, she's like, girls are weird. And I'm like, well, I don't know. Because girls are weird.
But would it be in, like, oh, wait, they have to be in high school to do that stuff?
Yeah. So, as long as I'm still teaching, there's still an option for us.
Oh, okay.
Once I get done, here's the other thing in my future. I figured out when I can retire.
When?
56. And guess what I'm going to do at 36? Freaking out. I'm retiring. That's 12 years from now.
And you're going to go to concerts.
I
know. I'm going to play golf and go to concerts. That's it.
That's crazy.
I know.
Wait, how old are you?
I think I have to be 64.
What? Did you start teaching late?
No. I started in Texas 2013.
That's your problem.
That's my problem.
That's your problem.
I'll be 29.
Yeah,
that's
you're like.
My brother graduates.
You're like tier...
Forever away.
I'm tier three.
I heard about those things. Like, what is that?
Yeah. depending on when you started teaching, depends on when you can get 100% of your time. Like, I can retire at 56, but I won't be able to get 100%. But I found out if I retire at 56 and not go claim my money until 60, then I can get it. And for three and a half years, I'll sub twice a week.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I'll still do that.
Yeah. Or a lot of teachers do that. They come back and they sub.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because it's, you know.
I've seen my old librarian here.
Librarian.
Yes.
Library. Oh, we got 2 minutes. Lord Jesus.
Time flies when we're having fun.
We gotta get
all right.
All right, future self. Where do you see yourself?
Future self.
We're talking 10, 15, 20.
10, 15, 20.
Five.
Whoa.
Five, 10.
Well, I just graduated with my master's in April in administration. So, hey.
Hopefully.
Shout out to WGU. So, I am now in BISD's Aspiring Administrator Academy.
I did not know that.
So, calling out to all the admin, I would love to be working in BISD as an admin.
Nice.
Yeah. That's the goal.
I'm currently thinking about going back to school to be a school counselor.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah. But like little ones. I don't want to do schedules. I want to be able to talk to kids still.
Yes.
And be like, oh my God, I hear you.
I'm so sorry Johnny pulled your hair.
I'm so sorry. Do you want a snack? Sometimes you need to eat.
I know, for real.
Food makes everything better.
Yeah.
Agreed. I think so. Okay. I've said this to him. I don't know. Maybe I have. I think Amaya would be great. It's going to be a great teacher. Straight up.
100%.
I've been wanting to be a teacher since I was in sixth grade. I'm not even kidding.
Yeah. So. I think she'll be great.
She's going to be great.
Yeah. I could totally see her one day being in high school and being that, like, cool hippie teacher that's just like, guys, calm down. Let's talk.
No, for real.
I know.
What do we
We're here.
But I feel like, I don't know why, but I feel like I'm going to have, like, a major change. Like,
you're gonna cut your hair?
No, heck no. I would never do that. But I mean, like, as in, like, my not aura, kind of like that, but like, my, like, I don't know. I
don't get me,
like,
started on auras and crystals, like, guys. That's a whole other episode.
I've got
you covered.
I didn't know that about you. That's crazy.
It's all fake.
No.
Yes, it is.
Anyways, I feel like I'm gonna have a major change that. Yeah, I'm done.
Okay.
Change is good. I think that's it, because the bell just rung. I mean, we have to go to class and I have to be a teacher now.
Boo.
All right, so like, subscribe, do all the things you do on YouTube.
Yes.
Hopefully, comment
what your favorite part of this video was.
Hopefully, the next time we do this, we'll be in the actual studio that is supposed to have the lights up by the end of next week. So by next
week.
And
Joaquin will be here.
Right, Joaquin?
And stay tuned for a Crystals episode.
Yes.
We're not doing that.
Okay. I'm just saying.
All right. Peace out. Have a great day. Be amazing.
Bye.
Bye.